So with interval notation, first let's talk about the bracket. Okay? Now we use square brackets when we are indicating, okay, intervals using the interval notation. So you can have a square bracket. Now, in most cases, you can have two of them like that. Now, if you have got two square brackets like this, the square brackets indicate that the lower limit and the upper limit of an interval are both included. What I mean by that is, okay, let me write this. If I have got an interval like this, a is less than or equal to x, x is less than or equal to b, this a here is called the lower limit, and the b is called the upper limit. That's what I'm trying to say here. Okay? Right? So if you have got an interval, now that's another type of interval notation where we use the inequality signs. Okay? So, if you have got a case like this, where you have got a number, in most cases you just write a, then you put b there. What this means is that both a and b, okay, are included in the interval. Okay, that's what that means. Okay. So if you have got two numbers inside square bracket, it means both values are included in that interval. Okay? You can also have another case where you can have a square bracket first, then you have got, say, a, b, then you have got a circular bracket. Now, the circular bracket means that value which is inside the circular bracket, whereby in this case, the circular bracket is to the right of b, which means that b is not included in the interval, but a is included. So here we say a is included but b is not. Okay? You can also have a case where you have a circular bracket first, then you have got a square bracket last, which means A is excluded, and, or we say, but B is included. Okay? Then the fourth case, you can have two circular brackets. Okay? So the square brackets means there's inclusivity, the circular bracket means there's no inclusivity. Okay, so we can have A, B with both circular bracket means both values are not included. Both A and B are not included. Okay? So you need to familiarize with this. It's going to come back later when you are doing functions and so on. Later on, the grade 10 functions. Right? Now, we also need to connect this with the inequality signs. Okay, because you can either use the square or circular brackets, you can also use the inequality signs. Okay, now with the inequality signs, let me move on to the next page. Okay, we need to move a little bit quickly. Can I carry on? As you are behind, you can catch up later. Now, if we connect the square brackets and the inequality signs, so if I give you A, B like that, in terms of inequalities, or using writing the interval notation using inequalities, this is the same as A is less than X is less than B. If you have got something like this A, then a square bracket on the right-hand side of B, this means A is less than X only, but X is less than or equal to what? To B. Right? Then you can have a square bracket first, then which means A is included, okay, but B is excluded, so that will mean A is less than or equal to X, but X is less than B. Then you can have two circular brackets, that means both X and, sorry, both A and B are not included. Okay, so that's the interval notation that you are going to encounter a lot as we move forward. Now, generally, we don't use the set builder notation. We normally use the interval notation. Okay, but you have to know what it's like. Okay, if you use the set builder notation when the question does not specify which method, which notation you're supposed to use, it's still fine. Okay, so let's move on to the examples. Okay, just allow me, I need to bring those questions back. Okay, so for this exercise, question 2 is on interval notation. Question 4, set builder notation. Question 6, set builder notation. Question 8, interval notation. Okay, so we've got 2 questions on interval, 2 questions on set builder. So we are going to use those notations to represent the information on a number line. All right, so let's start with the first one, number 2. Number 2, we are given that minus 2 is less than or equal to x, x is less than 5. Okay, which means the 5 is not included, but the 2 is included in that interval. Okay, remember when I first started the lesson on Monday, maybe Friday. Okay. I told you that we represent inclusivity by a shaded dot. Okay, the unshaded dot means the value is not included. So we're going to use that here. So I'll draw my number line. Okay, I'm mainly concerned with minus 2 and positive 5. So if I put my minus 2 there, okay, maybe I'll put my 5 there. All right? I'll start with the minus 2. It is included because there is a square bracket to the left of it. So I'll draw a small circle, then I'll shade it on top of the 2, right? And then there is a circular bracket to the right of 5. The 5 is not included in that interval, okay? Then I'll draw a circle, but I won't shade it. Now, when you've got a case like this here, it means that your x is a real number, okay? It means your x is a real number. Therefore, you can draw a horizontal line to join those two circles. Okay? It's a real number. That's why you have to do that. Yes? Okay, I'm going to re-explain it. Okay, can you come again later? I'm not getting too much of it. You can try to speak up a little bit. Okay, now that one now is mainly for integers, whole numbers and natural numbers. The one is that you put dots on each number and you shade it. That's when you are dealing with integers. Okay? But remember, your integers are also real numbers. And our real numbers, they also include rational and irrational numbers. So when you are dealing with the real numbers now, you have to use a line. Sorry? Yes. Remember, your integers are also whole numbers together with their negatives. Don't forget that. So if I give you a number, let's say 2.2, is it an integer? No. Therefore, when you're asked to indicate now the integers, you don't need to join the values for the integers with a line, because the values between integers are not, they are actually irrational. Okay?
some of them are also rational in terms of building fractions. So we want that the whole numbers together with their negatives, including zero.
Okay, don't complicate it. Yes? Sorry?
It's the whole number that are part of the okay? The natural numbers and the whole numbers, they are all integers. Together with their negative.
We are
drawing a line because we are including values that are both rational and irrational. Between minus 2 and 5, but the 5 is excluded. When you say we are putting rational and irrational, means all the decimals, they are also part of that interval. When you have a case like this, if I give you, say, x is an element of integers, and then I say x, or maybe I'll say 2 is less than x, x is less than 5. How many integers are in this interval? How many integers are in that interval? Huh? You start, wait. You start with 3, well, the 2 is excluded, then you have got a 4. The 5 is excluded, so you have got what? 2. Can you pay attention? Pay attention. Right? So, if I ask you to draw a number line for that one, for this one, make sure you pay attention. For us to draw a number line, you draw it like this. You put, say, your 2 here, and the 3 there, 4, then you what? Your 5. Now, because we only have 2 integers in that interval, that is 3 and what? And 4. So we go to the what? To 3, we draw a circle, and we shade it. We go to 4, we draw a circle, and then we shade it. And then we stop. Because the interval only consists of what? 2 integers. And your integers are whole numbers, and they are also natural numbers together with their negatives. So it means that if I were to say, give you say 2.5, would you include it in that interval? You can't, because 2.5 is not an integer. You can't. If I were to give you say square root of 5, can you put it in that interval? You can't, because square root of 5 is not an integer. So there are only 2 integers there. Okay, and the only way that you can indicate them or represent them on this number line is by drawing a number line, then you can get with 2 shaded circles, one with 3, the other one with 4. Okay? Then, when it's not specified now, like in this case, question 2, it means we are dealing with real numbers. That is, natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, all the rational numbers, and all the irrational numbers. They are part of that interval. So, if you want to include numbers that are not integers, you have to draw a line to join the minus 2, which is included, and the positive 5, which is excluded. This horizontal line here, it indicates that we are including all real numbers, because we are dealing with real numbers. Okay? Right. I hope you understood. Let's get on. The next one. Now, the next one is on set rule denotation. We need to draw a number line for it. But you see that it says x is an element of what? Integers. Now, how many integers are included in this interval? Before we go anywhere. We are starting from minus 3, but the minus 3 is included up to 2. How many integers are there? You can use your fingers. The minus 3 is included. It means minus 2.
4.
Minus 1. Okay? Minus 1. We have 0. Don't forget that 0 is an integer. Then we have got positive 1. The positive 2 is not included. Okay? So for number four, right, for number four, let me go to the next page. For number four, we have got x is such that minus 3 is less than or equal to x, but x less than 2, where x is an element of integers. Okay? That's what you got there. Right? So when you indicate that on a number line, okay, I'll start with the minus 3 there. Then I can have, please, you must use the ruler when you are doing this. You said the folder doesn't have a ruler. So my ruler is actually my eyes. Okay? Like that. Since we are dealing with integers, okay, the first circle which is shaded is going to be at minus 3, then the second one at minus 2, then at minus 1, 0 is also an integer, and then 1. We can't indicate 2 because 2 is excluded. 2 is not part of that interval. So we only have how many values? 5. 5 values that are part of the interval. Yes? No. Don't do anything above the 2. Okay. Don't shade, don't do anything. Just stop at positive 1. Okay? Okay, let's move on. Number six, x is such that x is greater than or equal to 2, but x is a real number. Okay? Don't forget, your real number comprises of natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, rational numbers, and all the irrational numbers. Okay? So that one there, it's x is greater than or equal to 2, so it's x is such that x is greater than or equal to 2, but x is an element of real numbers. Now, this one here is so simple. Just draw the number line. Okay? We have got 2, we need to talk about all the values to the right of 2. So if I put my 2 here, since there is an equal sign there, I'll draw a circle then on top of it, then I'll shade it. Then my arrow is going to point to the right. Okay? It's going to point to the right. And that arrow is going to indicate that all the real numbers are included in the interval. So we are starting from positive 2 up to positive infinity. Okay? So x can be any number from positive 2 up to positive infinity. There is no specific restriction from positive 2 up to infinity. Okay? Now, Keron, are you following? Right. Let's move on to the last one. The last one says minus 4 is less than or equal to x, and x is less than 1. Now, this one here, when you've got, when it's not specified whether x is an integer or it's a natural number, the assumption will be it's a real number. Okay? So, we'll say number 8 is minus 4 is less than x, x is less than 1. Okay, I hope I'm putting it correctly. Alright, so this one here is very simple. Just draw your number line. Your minimum there, you can put your minus 4. Now, there is no need for you to put the integers between minus 4 and 1. There's no need. Okay? So we'll put here 1 there, but the 1 is not included. So on top of the minus 4, we draw a circle and then we shade it. On top of the 1, we draw a circle, but we don't shade it. Then we join the 2. Okay? Then we are done. Okay. All right. Any question? Now, the interval rotation is going to come back later. I'm going to remind you that, remember, in February we did the interval rotation. It's going to come back as part of application. And also, the inequalities, we are going to do a topic on inequalities later on, okay, during the course of this chapter. Okay. Right, any question? And if you don't have a question,